everyone, welcome back to GK Today. I'm Nuzhat Sana and in this video I'll discuss today's top current and static general studies questions for UPSC prelims examination 2022 onwards. And these questions are framed keeping in view both the factual as well as analytical aspects of UPSC prelims exam. Also, I would like to inform you that these questions are part of GK Today's UPSC prelims test series, which is available in GK Today Android app. And the test series for 2022 prelims examination comprises total of 7500 questions, divided 2500 questions on current general studies and 5000 questions on static general studies. And the series has started from May 2021 and it will end with UPSC prelims examinations 2022. So if you wish to access all questions of GK Today UPSC prelims test series, you may subscribe the test series in the app. So now without wasting any further time, let's get started.
Today this is our lecture number 32 and now let's start. Question number 1, which of the following cattle diseases are caused mainly by virus? So we have to identify which among the following are viral diseases, okay? First is brucellosis. This is actually a bacterial disease caused by the Brucella bacteria and it is highly contagious and is transmitted through unpasteurized milk and undercooked meat. So this is wrong. Second is anthrax. This is also not the viral disease, rather it is bacterial disease and it affects basically our cattle. Also it is caused by bacillus anthracis and is transmitted via spores. So again it is wrong. Third is foot and mouth disease. This is a viral infection that affects our cattle and it is caused by an aftovirus called as FMDV. Fine. So this is right. And last is blue tongue disease. This disease is actually caused by blue tongue virus in sheep and cattle and it is transmitted through small flies called midges. Fine. So this is also right and correct answer becomes only 3 and 4. Now apart from it, talking about some more viral diseases, examples are chickenpox, smallpox, common cold, then AIDS, measles, rabies, mumps, etc. Fine. And talking about bacterial diseases, examples are whooping cough, cholera, leprosy, then tetanus, typhoid, TB, plague, etc. Okay? Also important thing is rabies is a viral disease that is caused by Lisa virus. And hog cholera, also known as classical swine fever, is caused by pesty virus and it infects mostly pigs. Okay, then there is a disease named as Rinderpest and it is also a viral one that affects our cattle. Fine. Now moving to next question. With reference to India's wildlife as well as protected areas, consider the following advices to an enthusiastic traveler. So let's check the statements. First is, to see Chinese pangolins in wild, one should visit Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary. So this sanctuary is an eco-sensitive zone that is located in Assam and it is a wildlife sanctuary noted for its population of Assamese, macaque and Chinese pangolins. So obviously to see Chinese pangolins, one should visit Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary. This is right. Second statement says, to visit only National Park of Bihar, one should visit Valmiki Tiger Reserve. Actually the Valmiki National Park is the only national park found in Bihar and it is a tiger reserve as well as national park both. So apart from the Bengal tiger, the park also has Indian rhinos and clouded leopard. Also it is an eco-sensitive zone. So this is also correct. And third statement says, to visit Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary, one should go to Churao Islands in Goa. Actually Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary is an eco-sensitive estuarine mangrove region that is located in Churao Islands in Goa and this island lies in Mandovi River. Fine. So correct answer becomes all 1, 2 and 3, that is option number D. Now let's talk about some of the important national park, tiger reserve or wildlife sanctuaries that were in news. First is Mukurthi National Park, that lies in Tamil Nadu, and it was in news because Tamil Nadu government is constructing fire lines, or you can say fire breaks, ahead of summer and peak fire season. Then second is Madhav National Park. It is in Madhya Pradesh and it was in news because of encroachment issues. Okay. Then third is National Chambal Sanctuary, that lies in again Madhya Pradesh, and recently it has been declared as an eco-sensitive zone. Then fourth is Kanha National Park and it is in Madhya Pradesh and it was in news because of increase in population of hard ground swamp deer, or you can say Barasingha. Okay. Now next is Bandipur National Park or Tiger Reserve. It lies in Karnataka. And few time back, there was a ban on vehicles movement on the forest stretch of NH-766. Then there is Sanjay Gandhi National Park. It lies in Maharashtra. And it was in news due to death of last captive white tiger named as Baji Rao. I am making some space here as well. Okay. Now seventh is Rajaji National Park or Tiger Reserve, that lies in Uttarakhand. And it was in news because Supreme Court halted further construction of the Kandi Road project which passes through the park. Then eighth is Kaziranga National Park, that lies in Assam. It basically split into two divisions, the existing Eastern Assam Wildlife and the new Biswanathan Wildlife Park. Okay. And in between these two, Brahmaputra River flows. Fine. And now ninth is Singhfun Wildlife Sanctuary, that lies in Nagaland, and recently it has been declared as an elephant reserve. And talking about fourth national tiger estimation, Dampa Tiger Reserve, that lies in Mizoram, emerged as the worst managed tiger reserve in India. Pench Tiger Reserve or National Park, that lies in Madhya Pradesh, along with Periyar National Park, that lies in Kerala, emerged as the best performers in this tiger estimation list. Okay. So these are some of the important tiger reserve, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. Next question. Consider the following statements. Semiconductor manufacturing has an extremely high specific energy usage. Yes, this is right. And second statement says, though Bitcoin is a virtual currency, its mining is a high energy consumption process. First of all, let's understand what is cryptocurrency. Actually, it is a specific type of virtual currency which is decentralized and protected by cryptographic encryption techniques. For example, Bitcoin, Ripple, etc. Fine. Now, what is Bitcoin? It is actually a type of digital currency that enables instant payments to anyone. And it was introduced in the year 2009. And it is based on an open source protocol and is not issued by any central authority. Fine. And yes, Bitcoin price has always been volatile and there is no clear explanation for its rise. Now, what is Bitcoin mining? Actually, it is the process of creating new Bitcoin by solving complex computational math problems using high powered computers through a power intensive process. And hence it is linked to high levels of carbon emission as well. So on an average, solving a complex problem and processing a block in the network takes 10 minutes. And a huge part of the Bitcoin's energy consumption is during this mining process, which is incentivized through newly created Bitcoins and transaction processing fees. So the energy consumption, especially from the fossil fuels, increases with increase in price of Bitcoins. Okay. So this is also right, and correct answer becomes both 1 and 2. Now why it was in news? Because recently Bitcoin has crossed $20,000 in value. And the issue is that ever increasing attractiveness for crypto mining is leaving way for new threats in the cyberspace, and cryptojacking has become the latest threat to the computers worldwide. What is cryptojacking? It actually targets popular websites which draw audiences numbering in the millions every day, and once the malware patch has been embedded on a website, it infects the web browsers of visitors. So at last it slows down the machines and often causing them to heat, and then it uses it for mining cryptocurrency. Fine. Now next question is, with regard to various sections of Indian Penal Code in news in recent times, consider the following matches. So we have to check if the section and the related term that has been written here is correct or not. Okay. First is section 124A, sedition. Actually, this article deals with sedition, yes, and it provides for penalizing seditious activities with a prison term of up to 3 years and a fine. Now, why it was in news? Because Supreme Court has recently protected a political leader and 6 senior journalists from arrest in a multiple sedition FIRs registered against them. And this section was inserted in 1870 by an amendment introduced by Sir James Stephen when it felt the need for a specific section to deal with the offense. So basically this section defines this article as any person by word, either spoken or written, or by sign, or by visible representation, brings or tries to bring into hatred or contempt to excite disaffection towards the government established by law in India, then it would be a non-bailable offense. Okay, so this is right. Second is section 153C deals with financial crimes. Actually, this section is a proposed section under IPC that was proposed by Vishwanathan Committee, and the basic motto of this section is to deal with hate speeches and not financial crimes. Actually, in the year 2017, a committee headed by former Lok Sabha Secretary General T.K. Vishwanathan submitted a report recommending the strict laws to curb online hate speech, and hence it proposed inserting section 153C and 505A in the IPC for incitement to commit an offense on the grounds of race, religion, caste, sex, gender identity, sexual orientation, place of birth, residence, language, disability, or tribe. Okay? So this one is wrong. And third is section 304B, dowry death. So this section deals with dowry deaths and a death of a woman due to bodily injury that occurs within 7 years of marriage and is shown to have suffered harassment or cruelty soon before death by the husband or his relative is considered a dowry death. And it was in news because recently Supreme Court has widened the scope of section 304B of IPC by indicating that there is no straitjacket formula to determine the cruelty against women. And some more sections related to women are section 498A. It deals with cruelty by husband or his relatives. And then second section is section 113B. It is presumption as to dowry. It deals with presumption as to dowry death. Okay, so this is right, and correct answer becomes only 1 and 3. Now last question, which of the following can be hypothetical implications of runaway greenhouse effect on Earth? First of all, what is this effect? Actually, it refers to a situation where the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere reach sunlight levels as to prevent the thermal radiation from leaving the Earth. And such an effect prevent the Earth from cooling, and it would leave no water left on its surface. Also in such cases, water from the surface reaches stratosphere and can escape into the space through hydrodynamic escape. And this positive feedback effect leads to desiccation of a planet, as is supposed to have happened in the early years of planet Venus. So according to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, that is IPCC, such a runaway greenhouse effect cannot occur on Earth, as there is not sufficient carbon dioxide to block the outgoing long wave radiation. Okay. Now let's see the options. It may prevent Earth from cooling. Just I've told you. Yes, this is right. Second is Earth may not have liquid water left. Yes, there would be no water left on its surface. And third is water may escape into space. Yes, because all the water would reach to the stratosphere. Correct answer is 1, 2 and 3. Now why it was in news? Because on planet Venus, the excess carbon dioxide traps most of the heat from the sun, and cloud layers act as a blanket, creating this runaway greenhouse effect recently. And the temperature of Venus can soar up to 465 degrees Celsius, even higher than Mercury's, which is the closest planet to the sun. And as the sun becomes 10% brighter in about 1 billion years time, the surface temperature of Earth will reach 47 degrees Celsius only, covering the temperature of Earth to rise rapidly and its oceans to boil until it becomes a greenhouse planet similar to Venus today. Okay? So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. If you want to give any review, feedback or suggestion regarding these lectures, you can tell us in the comment section. Definitely we'll try to implement that. And now we'll meet again tomorrow with 5 more new and interesting questions. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Zatsana signing off.